I'm off to a very favorite part of Bombay, Kotachi Wadi. I don't know if you've heard of Kotachi Wadi, lekin this is this quaint little untouched part of Bombay, I would like to think. And it's untouched to whatever extent thanks to people like the person I'm going to visit today, James Ferreira. It's a centuries old little settlement. It has these beautiful wooden Portuguese cottages, and it's right in the heart of South Bombay, where it's surrounded by these high rises. And the pressure has been over the decades to get rid of these cottages and yes, build those little matchboxes piled up on each other. From what I understand, out of the hundreds, 150 odd such cottages and such bungalows that were existed, there are only 28 of them left. But it has a beautiful, sleepy, little, amazing, quaint spirit, and it's retained its quirky character. Yes, let me not talk too much about it. Let me just take you there. So off we go to Kotachi Wadi. This is the most incredible magical place. That's a little turtle. Please check out that little fountain. Yay! Clothes, clothes, and beautiful clothes. A joy! And here we have James sitting in his gorgeous, beautiful house. I think possibly one of the most favorite houses I've been to in Bombay. I'm going to take you around it after this. So James, want you to tell us something about Kotachi Wadi. I've been telling the guys in my blog that it's possibly one of my most favorite corners in the city. But tell us something about it.
Kotachi Wadi is a kind of a village which Bombay has grown around. These houses are about 220 years old, and the land was leased to the East Indian community and the Patari Prabhus when Bombay started to develop as a port city. Over the years, the city has grown around it, and the wadis, which were the plantations which surrounded Kotachi Wadi, became those old Victorian buildings, and those are now giving way to high rises. So what I've tried to be saving this from the past 10 years, and I've started the Kotachi Wadi Welfare and Heritage Movement to start it.
Just to keep it topical, we've been hearing a lot about the amazing showing you had at the Will's Fashion Week, and I'm personally a huge fan of your clothes, and I believe you always seem to catch the pulse of the country at the right time. Just to tell you, I was part of the Anna Hazare movement, where I performed to the 20,000 people here at the Azad Maidan, and cut to seeing your clothes on the internet, because I was not fortunate enough to be in Delhi. And I was blown by the connection. I think it's something our country is feeling, but you managed to translate a feeling that all of us have. I don't know, was it conscious?
Because I started working on Khadi around 6 months ago, because it took me 3 months to develop the fabrics. But Anna Hazare happened in between, and so it just really fitted it really well. And I have been really kind of inspired by the quiet elegance of the Gandhi family. In this age of so much, and everything is possible, and when people are spending crores on a ghagra choli to wed, it's incredible that one of the richest families in India has been wearing a hand-me-down sari which was woven by the grandfather while he was in jail, which is just a simple khadi border with a shocking pink border. And I mean sarees with a shocking pink border. I mean, I think that is elegance.
Absolutely, and it looks gorgeous. Yeah. I think it's unmatchable.
Khadi is a brilliant fabric. It has the same properties as wool. It keeps you warm in winter and it keeps you cool in summer.
Right. Well, I just want everyone to see... Oh, you don't have to run away. It's part of the... Okay, we are yet in James' gorgeous house, and if all this isn't gorgeous enough, here's the most gorgeous one of them all, James's mother. James, her name?
Thelma.
Okay, she stays downstairs?
Yeah, she's 90 now.
That's possibly one of the most beautiful faces I've seen in... How beautiful is this? In which year was this shot?
This is 1947.
उसको मैं शायद माई
1947 डिड यू हियर दैट ऑल ऑफ यू.